see some films. That'll do it.
Shelter for New Sunday. The island boasts beautiful cliffs, forests, and a vast history.
The highest cliffs are found on the northwest side. It is home to two lighthouses, the East Channel and the North Light. Enjoy hiking, biking, and camping on the island. A wide variety of wildlife can be found on the island, including fox, white-tailed deer, painted turtles, red squirrels, bobcats, and black bears, among other animals. The East Channel Lighthouse was built in 1867 to guide vessels in the Anderson Harbor from the east. The location opposite the beam of the shoal at Sand Point was critical for safe navigation. The lighthouse was abandoned in 1913. It is now privately owned. We will now take a ride over to Trout Bay.
So how are we doing, guys? We all good? Alright, good deal. So something I hadn't mentioned previously, the island's a fantastic refuge for the American bald eagle. Good chance that we'll see an eagle or two as we make our way around the island, but if we're real fortunate, we may in fact see one that's perched on a limb or a cliff in an area that would allow us to get in close. And if that's the case, well, we'll get in good and close and take a good look at an eagle. We'll do that one time. After that, we'll simply just point them up together and continue making our way around the island. We've got a lot of beautiful sights to see, possibly some wildlife to check out along the way. So in the meantime, just kind of sit back, relax, and enjoy the amazing views. Next, we'll be coming up on the rotunda. Get covered in ice and it forms some beautiful ice caves. This is where the ice caves of Grand Island are formed, and there's even been a commemorative stamp published by the U.S. Postal Service recognizing the ice caves of Grand Island as beautiful. And you might want to come out here and take a look at them in the winter months, but you want to make sure that the ice that you're walking on is good and sound, so you can check local authorities. That's one way of handling it. Or possibly come out here with a guide service. I know there's at least one guide service that takes people to the ice formations here, as well as other locations around the island. And then there's ice formations on the mainland as well. There's a lot of them around the area. Basically anywhere you see wet rocks, well, there's ice that forms. And they're quite beautiful. I think it's worthy of a trip here in the winter. Take a look at the beauty that's in the wintertime. Got any adrenaline junkies on board? Somebody that appreciate that. Somebody that has a notion to maybe climb a frozen waterfall, that could be accomplished in the month of February. We have Ice Fest that takes place. We get ice climbers from all around the world that converge on the Munising area. Hope there's to take out inexperienced climbers as well as those that have a lot of experience. And so that's something that can be accomplished. But here at least, take a look online. You'll see a lot of beautiful pictures that are showing off the cliffs or the ice in the winter months. you guys probably noticed a little waterfall or two in advance of getting into this location in Tropee. And we'll see plenty more as we continue to make our way around the island. Now, the size of the waterfalls, as well as how many we see, is largely dependent upon what kind of rainfall we're getting and certainly the time of year. Now, Munise gets quite a lot of snow in the winter months, and of course, when all of that icy snow begins to melt in the spring, it makes for some beautiful waterfalls. And we'll get pretty darn close to some of them as we make our way around the island. Yeah, and I hope to get in nice and close to one on the west side. That's going to depend upon whether or not there's other boaters in the area at the time. On a day like today, it's kind of hard saying we may not be able to get in close here, but we'll give it a shot. Now, Grand Island was purchased by the U.S. Forest Service 32 years ago, and then they turned the island into a national recreation area. That designation allows us to use it for such things as camping, hiking, backpacking. You can snowmobile across the ice and onto the island in the winter. Bicycling, that's always a good time on the island. But you get the idea, there's plenty of things you can do on Grand Island. Now, the cliffs in this area, they're about mid-sized in terms of height, but they do get progressively taller as we make our way around the island. So between here and the North Light, we'll see cliffs that are taller than the ancient at the North Light. Well, we'll see some taller cliffs yet. But it's on the northwest and west side of the island, that's where we're going to find the tallest cliffs. And what I mean by that is, they are in fact the tallest of all of the pictured rocks formations. And that oftentimes comes as a bit of a surprise to people. I think there's a good number of folks that might guess the tallest cliffs to be found within the national park. And in fact, they're actually found within the National Recreation Area of Grand Island. But the truth is, guys, you know what, it really hardly matters whether you're looking at the cliffs of the mainland or the cliffs around Grand Island. What they all have in common is they're beautiful. Now, the term pictured rocks, that can be a confusing thing as well. I think primarily because the national park is named Pictured Rocks. And yet it's important to keep in mind that that term has actually been around for literally centuries in advance of the park even having been formed. Now, some believe it was the French explorer Pierre Radisson who coined the term pictured rocks when he was trying to describe the cliffs on this island as well as on the mainland. He was exploring the area back in the 1600s. Now, you fast forward to 1966, better than 300 years, and that's when the National Park was formed. Now, they decided to use the name Pictured Rocks. It made a lot of sense just because there's so many cliffs that are part of the National Park. And yet, it's equally important to keep in mind that there's even more cliffs surrounding this island than there is within all of the National Park. Now, I know we've not spotted an eagle yet, but keep in mind we basically just started this trip around the island. Now, with so much island yet to see, pretty good chance we'll see some more wildlife, possibly an eagle or two as we make our way around it. A falcon, I see a falcon. I think one of you up front that spotted that falcon as well. There's a lot of falcons that make the island their home. That's a good chance the eagle might have a fish, and that might be one of the reasons why the seagulls is after it, or after it, but I'm not sure. Seagulls tend to pick on eagles anyway. Okay. Must have fish or something, otherwise it wouldn't be so relentless.
Right there. See where that flash is.